this video, we will learn how to use Prefect and Pydantic to create a full stack machine learning application. To see what is useful, let's start with a story. Jeff is a data scientist at the rubber duck store. He is responsible for predicting the number of rubber ducks sold next month. Jeff needs to frequently adjust his feature engineering process and tune his machine learning models to get a highly accurate prediction. Thus, he finds himself spending a lot of time digging into his code to change the function parameters and observe the results. He wishes that he could change the parameter values from the UI, but does not want to spend time building a front-end application. What should Jeff do? Jeff is facing the same problem as many data scientists do. They want to iterate quickly on their machine learning experiments, but do not have the time and skill to create a nice user interface. That is where Pydantic and Prefect comes in handy. In this video, you will learn how to use these two tools to adjust your function input values through the UI and validate the parameter values before running the function. First, let's get started with creating a UI with Prefect. The source code of this video can be found in the repository Iris Prefect. You can find the link to this repository in the description below. What is Prefect? Prefect is an open source library that allows you to observe and orchestrate your data pipelines defined in Python. To install Prefect, type pip install Prefect. Let your Prefect UI to create a simple front-end application for your Python functions. There are three steps to run the function from the UI. The first step is to turn your function into a flow. The second step is to create a deployment for the flow. And the third step is to start an agent to run the deployment. Let's first start with turning your function into a flow. To learn how to do that, we will start with an example. Here we have the function process that calls the functions to load the data, process the data, and save the processed data. To turn this function into a flow, we will start with import flow from Prefect. Next, we will add this decorator to the process function. Now that we have created the process flow, we will create a deployment to run the flow from the UI. A deployment is a server-side concept that encapsulates a flow, allowing it to be triggered via API. To create the deployment for the process flow, inside the process.py file, we will type the following command in the terminal. -n iris process specifies the name of the deployment to be iris process. -a tells Prefect to simultaneously build and apply a deployment. To view your deployment UI, sign in to your Prefect Cloud account at app.prefect.cloud or spin up a Prefect Orion server on your local machine by running Prefect Orion start. Then click this URL to see the Prefect UI. In this tutorial, I will use Prefect Cloud, but you can feel free to use whatever you want. This is the first page that you will see if you are using a Prefect Orion server. Click deployment to see all of the deployment. To run the deployment with the default parameter, select the deployment, click run, click quick run. To run the deployment with the custom parameter values, click custom run. Under parameters, click custom, and you can see the input elements for your flow's parameters. Hey, if you watch this video and like it so far, consider click the like button. The number of likes in this video will inform me whether this video is helpful for you. Let's continue with the video. Prefect creates an input element based on the type annotation of a parameter. For example, text fields are used for label, raw file, raw location because their data type is string. A numeric field is used for text size because its data type is float. A multi-line text field is used for columns to drop because its data type is list. Let's enhance the UI further by turning raw location and process location to a drop-down and turning column sudo drop to a multi-select field. To do that, we will utilize list and literal from typing. First, we will change the type annotation of raw location and process location to literal. Literal data raw and data processed specifies that the parameter value can only be either data raw or data processed. We will also change the type annotation of columns to drop to title case list bracket string. To apply the changes to the parameter schema, run prefect deployment build again. Now, when you refresh the page, you can see that drop downs are used for raw location and process location, while multi-select field is used for column sudo drop. To view all of your flow runs, click the flow runs tab. You can see that the status of the two latest flow runs are late. This is because there is no agent to run the deployment. Let's start an agent by copy and paste this command on your terminal. Awesome! The two latest flow runs are picked up by the agent and are marked as completed. To view the values for the parameters used for this run, click the flow run, click parameters, and you will see the information of the parameter values. Pretty cool. In this video, you learn how to utilize Prefect to create a front-end application for your Python function. In the next video, you will learn how to validate parameter values before a flow run is executed. Thank you for listening.